looking at the bank stocks currently.
So, you know, Ankur, this is one of those days where there is so much to discuss, and I know we've extended our appointment with you. I'm going to keep my last question very simple. Are you a buyer in this market? If yes, where are you nibbling and where are you shopping?
I think the two sectors that look really interesting right now is basically the banking sector and the housing finance companies. I think that's a secular growth story. And if you're a long-term investor, I think it's a good time to be looking at that spot right now in the market.
Okay, Ankur, good chatting with you. Just so much happening in terms of earnings as well as the market weakness. Got to address one, Seb, but we will chat with you once again in a few days from now. That was the view on the banking pack, but let's address the NIIT numbers. Rahul Patwardhan, CEO at NIIT, joins us on the show right now. Mr. Patwardhan, if you could just walk us through what the key takeaways have been and the highlights this quarter.
Yeah, thank you. It's been again a very good quarter for NIIT. We've tracked exactly to our plan for the third quarter in succession. Revenue is up 6% vis-a-vis the same period last year, up from 4% and 5% in quarter one and quarter two. Our EBITDA margin is 6.2% for the quarter as against 2.3% last year same quarter. Important to emphasize is this is traditionally the weakest quarter for the skills and career business. In spite of that, we have done very well. Our PAT has grown sevenfold from 18 million last year, same quarter, to 137 million this quarter. Our international business or our overseas business now contributes 70% of NIIT's revenue. And the split between the different business lines is 60% is corporate learning, 32% is skills and careers, and 8% is schools. And this is this was about 53, 32, and 11 1 year ago. Overall, the corporate learning business has continued to be very steady. Our top line grew 17%, and our EBITDA grew 12%. Was 12% as we had indicated. We've added one new customer in this quarter, MTS customer, taking our total to 27. Our order intake has grown. Our pipeline is very strong in this quarter. Our SNC business has also done well. We've seen 3% growth this quarter as against minus 3 in quarter 1 and 1% in quarter 2. So we said back to growth, back to profit, and we are delivering on that in this business. In fact, slightly ahead of that. We've had good traction in our beyond IT career portfolio and also in our international portfolio. And we're also doing very well in terms of new alliances and new products. So we had a new tie-up with Hewlett-Packard for testing and with Metascale for big data and a new program for the financial sector called FinAdvantage. So all in all, a very satisfying quarter, should I say. Not to forget, our two new renewal initiatives, StackRoot and NIIT TV, have made substantial progress. NIIT TV in particular, in 100 days from launch, we got 150,000 registrations for 140 countries around the world, and we now have 1,500 courses on this platform. Probably one of the fastest start in an e-learning portal that I've seen in the last few years. So overall, I'm pretty happy with the results.
Mr. Patwardhan, you know, just to stretch the point forward that you were making about Corporate Learning Group, which now accounts a hefty 53% of your key revenues and is indeed your growth pillar, do you expect the momentum in that segment and variant to continue over the next 4 to 6 quarters as well?
Yeah, as we had indicated, 15% top line growth is something we can see into the future. We are looking at all means to try to raise that through changing the profile of our contracts to larger ticket, bigger annuity deals. And we're also looking and exploring inorganic opportunities. But right now, 15% seems something that we can do. On EBITDA side, 12%, we're looking at productivity improvements, we're looking at product mix changes for higher margin products to see if we can drive up that EBITDA a little bit over the next few years. So overall, moving in the right direction.
Right. And what about your managed training services? What are the kind of signings that we are likely to see in the next coming few months?
Well, as I said, we had one new deal signed this quarter.
Okay.
In quarter one of this year, we had kind of consumed our entire pipeline. So quarter two, quarter three, we've been building up the pipeline. Right now, it's extremely rich. I'm hopeful that we will see more signings in this quarter and the next, but I'm not at liberty to obviously give you the details.
Let me get closing comments from you. Your margins, they stand at 6%. From 2 to 6, that's a big margin expansion. is the trajectory on the north side? Will margins continue to expand quarter by quarter?
Yes, I think if you do the maths, if CLG continues to deliver 12% as it's been doing, and SNC is starting to move from negative margins to break even now to positive, the trend is quite clear. The rate of change of that trend, of course, is a question, but margins obviously will improve overall for the company over the next few quarters.
You said it will improve. Is there a broader broader range you can share with us? Where will they settle eventually?
No, we are not giving out numbers because there's quite a bit of transformation process still underway. But definitely, there will be an improvement in margins quarter on quarter overall for the company.
So, Padmavathan, appreciate your time. Thank you for joining us. Stock on the screen, 76.
Thank you.
Was it 100 rupees a couple of weeks ago? I mean, everything's come down, so this stock is no different. And on a relative basis, this is not a mid-cap IT company. It focuses on skill development, so let's not paint NIT Limited with other IT companies or other mid-cap IT companies. Even housing numbers on your screen, what they've reported for the quarter gone by, uptick of 20%, net interest income continues to grow, and that's been the flavor of the moment for some of the for some of the market watchers, that housing finance companies, irrespective of the regime, interest rate cycle, they continue to